Hello, everyone, and thanks for joining us. My name is Kyle Henderson of BamaInsider.com. I wanted to talk to you guys about the offensive coordinator position at Alabama now that Mike Locksley has taken the head coaching position at Maryland. And so there's a couple things that I want to go over, and you can find all our recruiting and coaching nuggets on BamaInsider.com. I got a whole list of potential offensive candidates, but I wanted to talk to you about a couple of things right here on our YouTube channel. Remember to subscribe, and right now is a great time to sign up at BamaInsider.com. You can get all the team, all the recruiting nuggets that you can handle with our promotion, which you see right now on the page. So go over to BamaInsider.com. That'll last for a couple more weeks. Who's going to be the next offensive coordinator at Alabama, you ask? Well, there's a couple names floating around, and I think you have to start with the names that are already on Alabama staff, and you have to start with a guy like Dan Enos. Dan Enos, who is the quarterback's coach, that's his current role, as well as the offensive associate head coach at Alabama. He's done a fabulous job at Alabama in this first year, and he's clearly had a high impact developing quarterbacks like Tua Tagovailoa and Jalen Hurts. I think we've seen a lot of progression, especially from Jalen, year over year, and I think Enos has a lot to do with it. Enos has a ton of offensive experience, and he's been offensive coordinator before at Arkansas, and he was also a head coach at Central Michigan from 2010 to 2014. You also have Josh Gattis, who's a up-and-coming coach, just 34 years old. He's already the co-offensive coordinator at Alabama, along with the wide receivers coach. He already has the ACC championship. He's been a part of a Big Ten championship, and this past year, he won SEC championship with Alabama. He's done an amazing job with these wide receivers, and he's actually been involved in a lot of the run pass option play calling this season. So you have Josh Gattis on staff. You also have Butch Jones, who's an offensive analyst at Alabama in his first year following his departure as a Tennessee head football coach. Now, this is the same position that Mike Locksley had when he came to Alabama back in 2016. Butch Jones has a lot of experience. He's been the head coach at Tennessee from 2013 to 2017, works primarily with the offense, and he was also a head coach at Cincinnati and Central Michigan. He's worked the wide receivers, the quarterbacks, a wide range for Butch Jones. So what I think could happen here at Alabama, and you can read my full list of other candidates, including guys like Hugh Freeze. I know he's a popular name for Alabama, as well as Rich Rodriguez. And you can read more on the inside scoop on BamaInsider.com. But here's what I think could potentially happen. I think Dan Enos certainly has to be the front runner for this offensive coordinator position at Alabama. And then after that, you're going to have other guys that you can elevate and add on to the offensive staff. There's some other news out there about Pete Golding, who was recently contacted by Oklahoma and Ole Miss to join their staff as a defensive coordinator. From what we've heard, Pete Golding has turned those offers down to stay with Alabama. Now is a perfect time to subscribe. Think about it. What better time than now to become an annual subscriber at BamaInsider.com? College football playoffs, insider team news, potential transfers, assistant coaching changes. National Signing Day is on December 19th, and Andrew Bone's got a ton of scoop at BamaInsider.com regarding where the coaches are this week. So head on over to BamaInsider.com. Look for the promotion. The promotion code is 99Cyber. Hope to see you soon at BamaInsider.com. We hope to earn your business. Talk soon.